he was in the house, on the front porch, or in the field.
Well, you know what about that? You know, because I was biracial, and when I was young, I mean, it's weird because I told you before briefly, I'll just say that, you know, depending on what age I was, I looked either whiter or blacker or Hispanic or whatever. So when I was younger and I'd be around and I'd go visit my father and stuff before I was like, I don't know, between like 5 and 10 or 11, I would go visit him occasionally and I'd see my cousins there who were my cousins, some of them, and some were his wife's cousins, nephews and nieces. And I'd be playing around, you know, playing basketball or something, because I hated to play basketball, but I would do it because that's what they were doing. But anyway, and I'd go out there and play basketball. And I remember one time they asked me, I was out there playing basketball, and my dad and my uncles and stuff were playing at a different basketball hoop, and we were playing at another one on the same courts. And anyway, and so we were playing the game, and they go, "Are you black or white?" I'm like, "I'm both." And they go, "But are you black or white? Pick one." I go, "I don't want to pick one. I'm both."
Oh,
and
wow.
So they kept telling me this. And so finally I said, "Fuck, I'm white then." I just pissed them off. And they go, oh, he said he's white. He said he's white. To my dad. My dad says, "What?" Like that. And it pissed everybody off. I said, "What the fuck difference does it make?" And they said, "Well," but I was going to say, every time I go to see my grandmother, my dad's mother, she'd go, "Oh, you look just like your mother," like that. She goes, it would piss my father off to no end every time I saw her. But they would always look at me, and it made me uncomfortable because, and this is kind of the reverse of what you're saying, because it made me feel bad about myself that they would see me and they'd think I was somehow, like some of the family, some of the black people look at me and somehow I was better than the other ones on the other side of the family who were darker. And I didn't feel that way, but they saw me that way.
It's the mentality.
And I think that's ridiculous. It's just,
oh, it's
just
totally ridiculous. It's totally ridiculous. But you was half, to them, you was halfway on the other side.
Exactly.
You was almost there, you know? Exactly. And it's funny because when I was growing up, and I think that's difficult, you bring that up, it's difficult for kids to process. I know when I was a kid, we had a white lady who lived behind us, and she had three biracial children. We knew they weren't black all the way. But as a kid, I couldn't process that. You know, I was like 4 or 5. They were my friends. It didn't matter, but I still didn't know what they were, because there was one that they all looked different, and there was one who was a little bit, maybe a tad lighter than me, mm-hmm. but lighter, but he had this fiery red hair, but he was biracial. Mm-hmm. His brother was caramel complected and had this gorgeous hair. Mm-hmm. And then his sister was about the same way. I guess there's 4 of them. And, but they was treated so poorly because my mom wouldn't allow it from me and my sister. You know, she's like, cause I remember on my 5th birthday, because my friends was called, and don't take offense to this, so I'm going to say this. My friends would call them half breeds. Mm-hmm. Remember back in the day, they used that term to disparage.
Yeah.
And so they weren't the cleanest kids. They were like the dirtiest kids in the neighborhood. And I didn't want them coming to my birthday party because I was stuck up way back then. And I was a mess. And so, and I told my mom, I said, "Yeah, I don't want the half breeds coming to my birthday party."
Oh my God.
I'm surprised I still have my teeth right now. She slapped me so hard. And this today, that would be child abuse. I can still feel the slap from 1976. And then my grandmother, she pulls me into my bedroom. She's like, "Well, if they're not coming to your birthday party, I guess you ain't going either."
Good for her.
And that was the end of that conversation.
Well, don't you think know? that all that, though, all that mess, all that thought is really in internalized hatred for yourself?
I don't think as a
race, because to me, to say to someone who's lighter, because look, that's the whole thing. When in the Victorian days and stuff like that, even before that, like 1700s stuff, before that, they would say, like in just the white race, white people would say, the whiter you are, the better you are. And so that somehow got applied to the black race. And they said, "Oh, well, the whiter you are, the black race." And so I think it's honestly just nonsense that's true. And so to me, it's like self-hatred. Like if you're really dark, like Seal or something, that's somehow less beautiful or less valid than someone who looks like Halle Berry or whatever, or Mariah Carey or something.
Yeah, it took me a long time to embrace my darkness. It took one of my really good friends, and this was like recent history, maybe in the last 15 years. And she, I remember, of course, I was gay, but I am gay.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh, I just love me a chocolate man. And she made me feel so good about my skin color and how beautiful, how my blackness. I have a really good, no, I don't have any blemish. I have really good skin, mm-hmm. but that's so conceited, right?
No, it's not. And that's like, you need to play up your positives. That's good.
Yeah, and so she made me feel so good about myself, and then all that melted away, you know, because somebody found me attractive. Because it used to be, you know, I was one of the darkest brothers in the bunch, and dark brothers haven't always been in style. You know,
right.
And so I thank Deb. Her name was Debbie. I thank her for that, because I had a long time to try to accept. Plus, being the darkest one out of the family, you know, I had sitting next to my grandmother. It's like, how she's your grandmother, and she looks like a white woman, and you look like you just come out from the boat, you know. I'm serious, and that's how I felt. And I have some self-hatred about it, but I've come a long way, baby. So I embrace it.
That's good. But you know, I don't think it matters if you are as black as seal, or you're middle of the road, or you're white as snow. I don't care who you are, whatever race you are, either. But specifically for me, I had a similar sort of issue too. I mean, it took for different reasons, because I'm biracial, but I had to really come to terms with loving myself and liking who I was, because it took me probably 20 years to get to probably 25 years, I'd say, to get to the point where I really began to love myself and like who I was, because I'd gotten all these messages my entire life that I was either not black enough, not white enough, not good enough. I wasn't, you know, I didn't fit here, I didn't fit there. And I wasn't, you know, didn't fit the mold of what society said was beautiful. And so I got all these negative messages through media and people and family and friends, you know, just so to me, it's amazing when somebody finally comes to terms with who they are, whatever it's about, and actually loves themselves. And so the fact that you finally got to that point and you're actually accepting who you are is good. But I think that is, my point is, even for someone, you're saying, yeah, okay, you're darker black person. Even for someone who's a lighter black person, it's still for them, I think, a struggle. Still, I'm saying everybody has their thing. You know what I mean? You may not think so, but they do. They do.
Yeah, I can prescribe to that theory. Like I said, I just know what my journey was, being one of the darker kids. There were some darker, you know. That's where we coined those terms of, mm-hmm. you so black, you blue, or you blurple, you know, you so black, you purple. So it's funny. But now I think in today's history, it's not as bad as it was, because now you have comedians. There's a whole book dedicated to black, you know, how black you are jokes.
Wow.
You know, so, oh yeah, and Chris Rock, you know, him and Eddie Murphy and some, and what's used to be the blackest Negroes in Hollywood, but look at them now, they've gained a couple shades.
Exactly.
They're the darker than used to be.
Yeah, that's true. Well, yeah, and I just think that, yeah, that's true. But I think things have gotten better to some degree, but I don't think, unfortunately, as long as there's racism, and I think that if you look, and this is the truth, if you look at the way a lot of especially racist, I mean, mostly racist people look at all races, whether it's a Mexican or like Hispanic, I should say, or Asian or black or whatever, they judge the quality of the person a lot of times by their skin tone. Seriously.
Oh, totally.
So even if it's a Mexican person, the darker Mexicans are looked at as lowly, and the lighter ones looked at as more beautiful. Same with black people, same with whatever. I mean, so I think it's just the most bizarre thing to me, though. I've never understood it. I understand where it comes from, because people have been programmed that way, but I've never understood why the amount of melanin in your skin determines your beauty. It just doesn't make sense to me. So I just go ahead.
Yeah, when you say about the Mexicans, I have a lot of Latino friends, and I've learned my lesson not to call out their different nationalities when I'm talking about the whole. I've learned to say Latino, because one time I mistakenly called one of my Puerto Rican friends Mexican, and lost his mind. I'm like, dude, he's like, oh, they're stupid. I'm like, wait a minute, y'all all speak Spanish, what's the problem? You know, and he was serious with it. So I'm like, wow, so it's just not in the black race. I'm sure the white race has their thing, and then the Latinos have their. I'm like, wow, that's deep when you really think about it. That's deep. It's totally programming. It's total programming.
That's exactly what it is, and people don't seem to be able to get that they're being brainwashed, and people are brainwashed every day by media, society, things we see on TV that are being perpetuated and reinforced every day that these messages are true. This is right, and people have to seriously, literally, like, go through reparative therapy, whether it's on their own journey or whatever, or going to therapy, actual therapy, however they have to get through it to actually deprogram themselves from what they've been taught all their lives. That's what I literally had to do. I seriously, because I spent a lot of my life, my earlier years, trying to be something that I wasn't physically, like physically trying to fit a mold that I would never be. You know what I mean?
Because it wasn't who you were.
Right. And that's, but the only reason I was like that was because that's how everybody said I was supposed to look. And that's, I never would have thought I was unattractive or not good enough or beautiful or whatever if I hadn't gotten those messages from everyone else. It was because I'd been bombarded by all these messages from everywhere else that this is beauty. I'm not. And I never saw someone who looked like me. I always saw people who looked like, you know, who had blonde hair, blue eyes. You know what? This is going to sound crazy to you, but I grew up with my mom's family who were white as day. Okay. So German and, you know, everything else. And that's what I was around. So culturally and like psychologically, that is that side of the family. I had great time, great fun, whatever. But culturally, I didn't feel like I belonged because I
didn't connect. Place.
Yes, I just did not connect at all. And it wasn't that I didn't like them or love them even. I had fun with them and stuff. I didn't feel like it was home, if that makes sense. Genetically, for some reason, I'm genetically just like my brain or whatever is the white side of me for whatever reason. So when I was growing up, even though I obviously knew what I looked like and I knew what I was, in my mind's eye, when I was like 16 years old, I saw myself. Does that make sense? Like, I'd go to the mirror. One time I went to the fucking mirror when I was 16 years old. I remember this day. And I was getting dressed. I was doing my hair and put my contacts in, whatever. And I was like, fuck, I'm ethnic. I actually said that out loud. And because I literally never looked at myself and saw myself. It's just really fucked up, so.
Society wants to categorize you. You exactly. have to be this way because this is how we perceive you. And honestly, when I first seen your picture, I thought you were Latino or maybe Mediterranean or something.
That's
like
what
that.
I'm like,
and then when you said earlier on our show that you have to process, you get your hair straight, and I was like,
yes.
What?
Yes.
I was kind of, not that I was floored by it, but I was surprised because most of the time, yep, and this is going to sound bad when I'm saying it, but I'm not saying it in a bad way. There is, some people come out with the good mix when there's a biracial child involved. Mm-hmm. Then there's bad mix. They're out there. I'm going to say it. They're out there.
Yeah.
And they don't get they get more of one. Here's the way. They get more traits from the black F.
Yeah.
Then you get the other. It's not equal. Mm-hmm. I think you got the perfect blend. Because you're one of the ones that got the perfect blend. Because I've seen some of my nieces, but cousins. And I'm like, wow, those kids are so attractive. You know?
Yes.
And because one of my cousins is darker than I am. And he married a white female with fiery red hair.
Mm-hmm.
The kids look like Greek gods.
Wow.
They have this crazy, the skin is like, it's almost, the skin is gold looking, but their hair is even golder. It's not blonde, it's gold. And I'm like, wow, I can't wait to see what you guys turn out. Because unfortunately, society loves beauty. And I think just on your looks alone, you're going to, if you want to, you'll succeed. Because these kids are absolutely drop dead. And these are kids I'm talking about. They're drop dead.
Yeah. And I want to say something about that. But first, I want to say something about what you said a second ago. It's true that it's very true. And exactly what you're saying. There is some. I mean, it's just true. Because I've seen some butt ugly biracial people. Trust me. I have. And I've seen some gorgeous ones, too, of course. But I just wanted to say that it really depends on their racial genetics. She's biracial, but she looks more black, okay? And her husband is white. And they got married and they had kids. Her daughter came out like I did, blonde hair and blue eyes, And however, as she aged, she stayed that way. I didn't mind. What's that? That picture? That's my daughter. She goes, what? Like that.
Yes. Yes.
So the funny thing about race is that that's why I always try to say to people that race is nothing but just how you look. That is all it is. And it doesn't mean shit. So you wouldn't know by looking at her what her racial background necessarily is. You just think you do. You think she's probably Swedish or some shit, but she's not.